स्टूडेंट्स, इन रियल नंबर वी हैव सीन ऑलरेडी सम लर्निंग आउटकम्स. वी हैव इंट्रोड्यूस्ड द टॉपिक व्हाट आर रियल नंबर्स एंड देन वी हैव सीन यूक्लिड डिवीजन लेमा. यूजिंग यूक्लिड डिवीजन HCF वी हैव taken this concept. Again, after that we have seen fundamental theorem of arithmetics. Using this we have found HCF and LCM. Now student, to be continued in that very outcomes, we will see one question, which is exemption point of view, it is very important to prove the given number is irrational mathematically. Questions are, for example, prove that root 2 or root 3 or root 5 or root 7, etc., are irrational. I am taking here one example of root 7. So question is, prove that root 7 is irrational. Students, there is no direct method actually. This is the method which is called indirect method, where we suppose the contradiction of to be proved. I mean, we have to prove root 7 is irrational, then we should suppose root 7 is rational. So this is the contradiction supposition. So let us start here. As you are viewing the content before you, where question is given, and we have supposed, let's say that root 7 is actually a rational number, which is equal to a by b, where you know a and b are integers, b is not equal to 0, and there is no common factor between a and b other than 1. Then mathematically we will write root 7 equal to a by b. On squaring on both the sides, we get 7 equal to a square by b square. And again in the next step it comes 7b square equal to a square. Is it okay? Now you see, what is the meaning of this step? When we say a square equal to 7b square, it means a square is divisible by 7. And this implies that a is also divisible by 7. Now, from this concluding step, a is divisible by 7, then we should suppose that a equal to something like here it is supposed that a equal to 7c. Now substituting a equal to 7c in the above equation, above result, we get 7b square equal to 7c whole square. On simplification, we get 7b square equal to 49c square. This implies that b square equal to 7c square. You see, here the similar step comes as previously we have got a square equal to 7b square, and we have concluded that this implies that a square is divisible by 7. So in a similar way, here result comes b square equal to 7c square. So it is actually in form of Euclid division, where we say a equal to b cube plus r. Since here r is 0, So it is the form of A equal to BQ. So this implies that A is divisible by 7. So here in place of A, that is B square is there. So we say B square is divisible by 7. And we know if A square is divisible by any number, then it's a that number whose square, that number is also divisible by that number. So this implies that B is divisible by 7. Now, to pay here attention. Previously we have told that A is divisible by 7. Now we are telling that B is divisible by 7. So from both we get this result that A and B both are divisible by 7. And now you see that we have already supposed there is no common factor between A and B other than 1. But here we see that no, 7 is a common factor between A and B. So this comes in contradiction. So this contradiction states that our supposition is wrong. And we have supposed that root 7 is a rational number. So this supposition is now wrong. Hence, root 7 is an irrational number. This proves here. So this type of proof is called to prove something by indirect method, by contradiction method. So in this way, you can prove similarly root 2, root 3, root 5, any single number containing root. And now we will, I hope that it is clear. Now we will see a question where sum of a rational and an irrational number, or difference or multiplication or division of a rational and irrational number, results always irrational. Such type of question, how it is proved mathematically, we will see in the next session. So thanks students, you just don't forget to comment, share, like and subscribe. Thank you. Have a nice day.